So here we are with my new box of Terry Ludwig pastels, a beautiful handmade American pastel. So I thought I'd try it on an American landscape, and what I've got is some lovely photos. I really love the colours in these photos around Kanab. We were there a couple of years ago and I just absolutely love these colours. None of these photos is exactly what I want, but I think I keep vacillating between which one I start with because the colours are all so fabulous. I think I'll start with this one, but I would like to put a little road in it. So I'm just going to keep that there at the top where you probably can't see it, but where I can, so that you can see the actual painting that I'm doing. So I'll be using the Terry Ludwig pastels, and I'll just be using a small palette of the hard Conte pastels that I just keep nearby for doing some of the blocking in. I won't be doing an alcohol wash underpainting for this. I've been using lately a foam core board that I've coated with the clear pastel primer, which gives it a gritty surface, and in this one I've put some aubergine-y kind of colour. So that's giving me my background purples in, sorry about my head there, it's giving me the background purples already in the distant hills and this big mesa there. So I'll just get on with sketching it in, and how I'm going to sketch this one in, actually I think I'm probably just going to use the dark charcoal for this one, and I'm going to just sketch in along the back here where the distant hills here, and just sort of block it in a bit of that massive there, and perhaps exaggerate that a little bit, make it a little bit bigger than in my actual photo. Photos are only a sort of jumping off point. Now the thing I really want to capture here is this other sort of mound coming down here, which is kind of, it's got the yellow colours that are sort of the contrast to that. And then it's just sort of grasslands to here, and then sagey shrub to here. I've got a big one here. I'm going to put in a road, and I think what I'm going to do is just make the road come around, curving around like like so. I'm not leading into the scene like so. And back here in the background we've got some more distant hills, and another sort of purple one going up there. So I've made that a bit big. So I'll just get my trusty rubber eraser and take some of that out. I've got the proportions slightly wrong there. In fact, this one is slightly less, and so is that. So very easy to erase it. I'm just going to put that back in a little bit lower down there. And that one coming out like that, and then another lot of pinker one out there, and a purple one up there. That one coming through in the background there. Just put in some little guidelines around here to show where the shadowed side is there. And that'll have some big sagey bushes there, brush bushes going back into there. Okay, so that's the general idea. I want to block in the sky. And then I'm just going to put in some background colours here. This is all pretty purple here, so I don't need to worry about that too much. But in here underneath the sage, I want to get the yellowy sort of red desert sand. First I'll start off with the sky, and I'm just going to save some of those. I don't want to use too much of the Terry Ludwigs, which are very soft on this first initial blocking in stage. So I'm just blocking in some of the areas that are going to be blue, some of the areas that are going to be the whiter clouds there. I'm just getting the vague shapes of those in. It's quite It was sort of a getting ready to storm clouds is what this was all about. They were quite white down around the rocks and the distant hills there. So I'm just going to put that all in as white for now, and we'll moderate it off with some of those lovely lighter colours later on. That's just to give me some sort of idea of how it goes. And there'll be some deeper shadows in amongst the bottom of those clouds. So I'll put those in. And I'll be going over that. That's just roughing it in. And then what I want to do is put in this, the colours that are going to form the basis of this row, and the desert sand underneath the faces. I'm just doing a bit of a block in there, and I'm going to use a couple of different colours, and then trees are all going to go under that. So the road sort of has a bit of, and it's going to be pinky colours as well. Yeah. That's the wrong colour entirely, Wendy. You just have to sometimes play with the colours a bit. I want it to be a touch redder, so it's probably going to come down to using that colour. I want to kind of stick with the box I've got here, and just because I'm just kind of trying out the colours. That's got a bit of pink in it too, so I'm going to put that in right now, and we'll come back to that as well. But that is one of the things I liked about it. It's kind of a yellowy, orangey colour, so I'm just getting those in, and then I'll probably put a touch of a deeper red in there. I might put a little bit of that in there. Not too much, just a touch of it here and there in the desert. And then just try. I haven't got exactly the colour I want, is my problem. And that's what happens when you get a new box. You're just working your way through them trying. So I'll just add in some of this colour. And you can see how I'm swiping it on its nice flat, because they're square. I'm swiping it on the flat edge of it to make the sort of tracks in the road. As it goes back there, we're not going to notice the tracks so much. Just a little bit of that colour to help blend in the that red colour, which is a little bit over the top, really. Of the track there, going up into the scrub in between there. And there'll also be some more purpley pinks in there, a little bit of some dryness on the tracks. For a little bit in those hills back there, just a touch of it. And I'm going to give this a wee bit of shadowy stuff in the tracks too. And along the edge there, where it starts to go underneath the sages, a little bit of shadow. and a little bit there. Okay, that's vaguely how it's going to go, and I will come back into that. What I need to do is put in some of the more of the colours in the sky, and I've got a beautiful selection here of very pale colours I'm going to use in the sky. So I'll just start with some pale sort of little touches of pink sort of in those clouds. And I'm just using, again, the flat side, not the edge. I started using the edge there, and you can see how sharp it's made it. So I'm just using the flat side and scrambling it around. I'll just soften those bits off a bit. Bring it down to there. Now there's just a lot of cloud in the sky, so most of it's cloud. I'm just going to get a whole lot of coverage of the clouds, and then there'll just be a little bit of sky showing through. So there I've got in that. Now I'm going to put in some of the grayer sort of, the lighter gray with a little bit of mauve in it down the base of those clouds to suggest the shadows in the clouds. There we go, just taking them right out to the edge, right up against the mountains there. And I will put some more pink in them, just some touches around there, warming them up a little bit. Just tying them in with the landscape a bit, so you can see that I've got the pinks in the landscape and the pinks in the sky, and so that will help tie it all together. In between, in the sky, actually I might put a little bit of blue in there as well, down the shadowed area. And it's coming along nicely. And sometimes there's even a touch of green, but the green I've got here is, well, maybe that one will do. Just, that's a very pale green, so I'm just giving it really, I'm just putting in a whole lot of warm and cool, very light colours to give the clouds interest, keep them lively. And now I've got to go in and put the sky in. I'm actually not looking back at my photo very much now that I've got the vague design in, and I'm just going to make it up as I go. Bear in mind that I live on a lush island of Tasmania. We don't have much desert landscape here, so it's all new to me, the desert colours, so it's interesting painting it. Now I'm going to put a bit of the sky colour in. I'm going to take this blue and see how that works. And just put a little bit of the sky colour in there, showing through some of the clouds. And I'll probably put some more clouds over that, because I really don't want much of the sky colour. It's a little bit too blue as it is there, but I'll knock that off a bit with a lighter blue. That's a little bit more greyed off. So again, just going around with the sides of the flat of that square pastel, knocking back the sky a wee bit, running some of that colour of the sky into the clouds and softening off the edges, and then I'm going to go back over with some of the lighter cloud colours. So that's putting the sky in. Might even take a little bit of a mauve colour now, a darker mauve colour, and put a little bit of that in the base of those clouds. just trailing off there. And now I need to go back in with the light. I've made the sunlight come in from this direction. There's a going to be shadows down there, and you see I've put the shadow on the road there, and I'll be shadowing that side of the hills, and so that side of the clouds are shadowed. But I do want to go back in again and give it a little bit more a light up, since once I put that on, I'm going back in with some lighter colours. I'm going to pink it up again in a minute. So it's just layer it over that bit I didn't get very well covered with the underpaint, the prep. Now you can still see I've got quite a bit of sky, holes in the sky from the background. I'm just going to give that a little bit of a smooth out in the sky section. Don't want to play with the clouds too much, but I'd like a little bit more coverage in the sky. It doesn't matter if the clouds have these darker colours peeping through, because it'll just be a bit of the sky background. But I am just smoothing off, not pushing it too hard, just a gentle swipe with my finger to cover up a bit of the colour in the from the background with the sky colour. Okay, now I want to put some more light back into those clouds, so in with the pinks, a little bit of fuzziness going on there. Don't want everything really well defined in the cloud, just some of it, and some of it's just floating away there. A little bit of light, so more yellowy white than a pinky white. So that's just where the sunlight's hitting it. And warming them up a bit. Just giving that a little tap off. Now I'm going to start on the background here. So I want to take some purples out. So here we go. This is going to be the purple from back here. And I'm just using the sharp edge of it. This is what's great about having square pastels. Lots of sharp edges for you to utilize. And over in this one, I've put that down. I'm just going to erase a bit of that cloud where I want to put the hills, because it's quite hard to get the darks to go really successfully over whites if they're too light. So I'll just take a bit of it out, and that'll get a bit of purple. And so will that one, but it's going to have a darker blue, a lighter blue as well. So we might go in with, maybe we'll go in with that purpley blue over the top of that, and a little bit here. But also some darker shadowed area, which will be the darker purple. So I've got a darker kind of purple here, which I'll put a few bits and pieces down with to indicate some shadowed area. And I'm just using the tip and for that. Again, not looking too closely at the reference photo for this, I'm just suggesting some shadowed areas there. to give it some definition. And the same back out here, I'm going to just put the edge on where that wasn't. Pull across and down, and the same over here. And as it comes down towards the base of it, it warms up a little bit. I'm going to put in some suggestions of pink in the base of it. And a little bit here. But I also want that deep pinky colour as well. I don't want it to be quite so pale back there, so I'm actually going to go over that pale one with the deeper pinks. There we go. So normally we don't want to be too warm in the background, because we want the back to recede by making it cooler. So I'm just putting a few at the base, and I'll probably cool those down a little bit as well as I go. What I want to do now is put in that deep edge of this side here now. And this is going to be going back through there, and that will come down the top of the mountain. The whatever you call these, buttes or mountains or whatever. So a few coming down that way too, just to give some shadows. There will be the odd little shadow in here where there's an overhanging rock. Just to give some hints of the shadows, over here is the other purple mound. Well, that's just a mound rather than a mountain, this one. So I'm just putting some shadows on that side of it. And then we'll come back into that with some different purples. So, we've laid in the shadows and we get some nice contrast there. Haven't started on the foreground yet, but I want to establish all this first. I think I've gone up a wee bit. I need to bring this up a wee bit higher, actually, so I'll just take that back out again, then we'll go over and just bring that whole thing up a wee bit. And so that means this will all need to come down the background, and I don't want it quite so dark, so I'm just going to use the lighter mauve colour now to drag down over the top of that till it sort of meets that background. And I'll give this just a touch up that's good. So they're receding here. I'm going to put a bit of ready pink, just a few touches of it. In fact, you might actually get a pinker pink. There we go, this is going to come into this as well. Quite a few pinks into that. The pinks will come out here too. There'll be a few suggestions of them amongst the shadows, and then quite a bit of it here. Uh, that won't stay quite that pink. I'm now going to take this warmer pink. That was sort of a cool mauve pink, and I'm just taking the warmer pink and putting some of that in as well, especially right up next to the shadows, and a few bits in there. That is going to get a bit more definition with the purples. So now it's coming together. You can see the receding distance, the clouds, the receding distance. This is coming into play. I do need to sharpen up the edges around here, and I'm going to do that with this, and again just using the edges, and not going to be as dark as around the other side, the shadowed side, but I just run a little bit of that through there. In fact, what it is on the edge there is more of that pink colour. So I've put in a base of purple, so the light's hitting it a bit more on this side, so I'm making it slightly pinker. Just putting some touches of pinks in amongst the purples around there. So again, I'm going to warm these up slightly. And through here there are going to be some shadow bits, so we'll put in some shadows. A little bit of grey, sort of a little bit of variation to mix it up down here. And just try that one for a little bit of sharp edge. And sort of a redder violety colour. And it's just warmer than the area in shadow, so I might use a little bit of that on this as well. So I'm just using this, red purple to help edge it as well. Just to give a bit of delineation there and warm things up slightly. The edges are great on this for making those kind of striations you get in the rocks. There we go. So that's looking fairly good. I'm going to just go back in now and maybe put a little bit more of that of a blue behind here. So just maybe a slight blue that off, and actually maybe use that blue a little bit to run along some of those edges there. To give it a bit more interest back there. I don't know whether it's now coming forward too much, so I might have to just give it a little bit of a knock back. A few shots of paler colours in amongst there. Okay. I want to give some definition to this little hill now. So I'm just going back in again with some sharper, harder strokes. And I want to have a little bit of variation in that. So I'm just putting some lighter areas by scrambling over it with a lighter sort of sagey colour, and a few darker areas, which I'm going to try and introduce with let's try that green. So I'm just going to do that greeny sage colour in there too. That's going to go all the way along here. It's a really good sagey colour for the to suggest the sage brush in the distance there. I'm just doing random strokes, not covering up all that underpainting I put in. Don't want to lose all that. So that's just coming across there. As it comes closer, I'm trying to do it more in sort of shapes, bush shapes, whilst leaving quite a bit of the desert floor showing through there. And I will need more than just that one colour, but that is an excellent colour. Thank you, Richard McKinley, for choosing that one. I want a little bit of warmth up in here too, so I'm going to add a little bit more of that yellow on this, on a little bit of a cutting coming in there. And that's just going to get warmed up a bit behind it there with the purple, which makes a really nice contrast to the yellow in front of it, which I'm going to just sharpen up a wee bit. And back in here, I do want to give that, come in again with this and edge it off a bit. Not real happy with this one back here, but I think what I'm not happy with is it's actually catching some of the sunlight up here on this face of it. So I think if I were to give it a little bit of a few touches of that, I might be happier. And then when it comes down here, it's losing the sun a bit, and so it becomes darker. And I might try that with the taking it off a bit with that. The blue. Yeah, I think that's made it more as I wanted it to be, although maybe it's too blue now. So you just have to keep moderating this, and I will. I'll just go back and just give it a bit of a blurry look there, and then a sharper edge along here. And I might do something more with it later, but for now it's just like so. That's coming together really nicely. I just need to choose a few more greens to put in there. So this one's a greyer green. So I'm going to put some of that on the lightest sunlit side of those sage bushes. So it is hard with the square ones to get the softer edges. You keep catching the part of the sharper edges on it. So that's giving them a bit of variety back there in the sage bushes. So, but I need to put some more in here, so we'll go back to that original one I had, and just start scrumbling them in. And so this is the sort of mid value of the brush. Okay, I don't want to. So I'm just getting a few of them in here. Just coming up over the road a bit. A few of them in there. So bigger as they come closer. Okay, so there they are. What I've got is two values there. The very light edge, the dark, the mid one. And then I'm looking for another value. So I could choose that one, or even possibly that one, but I think that's far too green. So we'll go with this grayed off green, and that's going to be the more shadowed side. And this is just to give it some form, those brushes. And they do sort of go have a sort of darker central bit and then the shadowed side there. So that's what I'm trying to pull back through this area as well, so we get some sense of variation as you start to come closer to the viewer. And I possibly do want an even darker one. And if I'm going to go for an even darker one, it's going to have to be that green. And I'm not sure that that's the right sort of green. Maybe have a touch of it in there. I don't know. I don't really like it. So maybe what I'm going to think about is in those shadows to actually try some purple. Purples in the shadows, although I've got a very dark green here. I wonder what that's like. Yeah, that's actually not bad for the branches. Although I might not go for green for the branches, I might go for a this dark. Almost black, but it's a more purple colour. And so we'll get some of the little branches in with that. I could actually also use a Conte stick if I wanted to here, but right now I just want to get some of those in, and then we can go back over them with sage and cover some of them up and try and get that very torturous look that some of those old sagebrush bushes have. Just coming up into there with a whole lot of little suggestions of branches, which will then use our greens to go over with a bit and cover up slightly. Just giving us a sense of the brushes in there, and might even come in with a little some purples in there. Shadowed sides as well, just to give some variety. So I'll pull in some of the Then I'm going to go back in with the sage green, just a bit of that. I don't want to lose all that purple I put in. I just want to knock it back slightly. And you can see that by laying the colours, I mute the purple a bit, but I do keep its effect. I make the green darker, and by putting the purple in as the base and then the green over it, I make the green darker, but I take the edge off the purple, and then going back in with the mid tones there. And then with the very light. Oops. We're just kind of on the tip of the sage, just there. Tip of the branches. Just a little bit of. I want some of it to be a little bit angular and sparky. So I'll just put in a few of those dots, less rounded, more spiky and sharp. Too round, it looks a little bit strange, so make it a little bit more irregular. Now it's kind of, I don't like the way the rove's going there, but that's okay, I can fix that, and what I'm going to do is make it come out that way a bit more. I pulled a awesome. Ended up putting those colours all in the wrong spot, and I like to keep them back vaguely where they belong. Road, actually, I want a bit of shadow there. A little bit of shadow there. And then what I'm going to do is pink it up. And warm it up there. And we might, with these ones here, make that shadow, make them come up quite a bit there, add a little bit more shadow in. Side over there. I need to put back in some branches and make this come in a little bit. The rose looking a little bit too regular there, so let's have it come in there a bit. A little bit of pink as well. And I'm going to put in a little bit of this lighter colour as well to suggest the sunlight coming in on the edges there. And And just so it doesn't want to run out the edge there, I'm just going to put a little bit of shadow across the road. There's a shadow there. So I need to build these up a bit, or they wouldn't be casting that much of a shadow. And I think I just need to rework some of those areas. Maybe not have quite so much. Knock it back a little bit there. Actually, I'm going to put in a little bit more up here. Just give a bit of mystery to that road. I don't want it all to be showing. So now I've put that in, I'm going to put in some darker bits. And I think I want to re-establish that again. Put some little bits, all of that showing through the... Kind of lost some of that. And just put a few patches in there. So we can tell that there's a ground in there. It'd be nice to have a little bit more hint of light there. So that's what I'm doing with that. That's good. Maybe get a few little bits of hot spot of light, a warm light on them. Sage as well. Just to catch a bit of the light there, a bit of warmness, but also I want to keep on with the silvery green colour as well, because that's the predominant. There are out in the desert here those lovely little pink rosy-like things too, and I'm tempted to put a few little pink flowers in the desert as well. Just to give it a little pail. Pail gets there. Just to give it a bit of a spark. I might even put some yellow. Been wanting to try out this one, so maybe a couple of little yellow drops back there, some sort of flower. Because we like a bit of colour. Well, I do anyway. And maybe that just needs a little bit of a tighten up here. So I know where I am, and right now I'm just giving them a, oops, that was nasty. A bit more gentle, Lindy. Just popping these back in their spaces. Got those the wrong way around. And I actually found another one I think I want to layer in there as well. It's a sort of bluer green and a darker shade. So that'll just give me a little bit more contrast there. Actually, up on this little thing here, there were a few little bits of shrubbery, so I just put those in with a darker colour. And there was a darker line along here, so I'm just going to put those in as well. I'm not referring back to the photo, just deciding what I think might look good, and I would like that to go in. Little bits that weren't quite so deserty blue, a little bit darker. Okay, now am I finished? I think just about. I just want to put some more of those. And here I'm just using the charcoal pencil to put in a few little branches. I actually prefer this one. I just have to be a bit careful with that I don't overdo it. As controllable as the charcoal. Some suggestions of them back here. I don't want them to be sort of coming out the bottom here, so I might actually take some of this and lead in a little bit with
some of the desert sands. Okay.
I still feel I've really, this is just such a no-no to have it coming right out the corner there, and I really stuffed that up. Not quite sure what to do about it unless I put a big bush in there. And that's maybe what I'll do, because it just takes your eye straight out of it there. So I think we're just going to stick in a whopping great sage bush there and stop that happening. That'll work. Give it a bit of don't forget to put some suggestions of, oops, that just broke, so I'll go back to this one. Some suggestions of branches in there, using the few touches of lighter colours in there, just a couple. But thanks for joining me in the studio today, and hope you enjoyed my demonstration of Terry Ludwig pastels. Thanks for joining me. See you next time. Bye for now.